Vern was okay. But it, see, the problem is when you get somebody that wrestles and then also is in the promotion, sometimes it's a good mix, sometimes it's not a good mix.
Mm.
I always believe that you got to do one or the other, because you always want to try to keep yourself up on top, you know, if you're in the promotion end of it, it made it a lot easier. You're following what I'm saying here. I
would. Yes. Yes.
So, and Vern, you know, to win, he liked the notoriety. It was a different situation in New York. Vince didn't wrestle. His dad didn't wrestle, but they promoted. So they did what they did best. And eventually, I think that would cost Vern the EWA went by the wayside, you know. And Vince came in and offered to buy him out, and then Vern had a saying, you know, once you're poor, you're never rich. And he said, I had not enough money. Well, a couple weeks later, Vince had taken over the TV, went to the TV stations and made his own deals. And so, and you know the rest of the story. Eventually,
yep.
AWA crumbled. So,
do you think that with the AWA, and like you said with Vern, do you think that a lot of guys backstage were kind of maybe like eye-rolling a little bit? Like, we just talked to Campaterra, and he's like, oh, of course, when I came in, Vern was the world champion, you know, kind of saying it, you know, almost jokingly. Do you think that was an issue with a lot of the wrestlers? They kind of thought that he shouldn't have been the champ when he was?
No, I'm not saying that. But Vern worked hard, trained hard, and don't get me wrong, was a good wrestler. But we're in a different time and a different age. I think that he wanted it all, and he really didn't know how to get there. He didn't have a lot of good people underneath him. You know, if you look at Vince's operation, you know, his production, his video, his audio, his preparation, everything was different. If you look at the two tapes, put them side by side, you'll see what I mean, you know, from the Calvin Beach Hotel to Madison Square Garden is a big jump.
Very, very, very true. With the AWA, when you got in to wrestling, was Vern your trainer? Did he kind of scoop you up and do actual training?
Well, I actually started with a guy named Joe Pazendak. People probably don't know that name, but he was an old timer at that time, but he was a good coach. I used to go down to the YMCA and when I turned professional, and I'd wrestle there, and I also trained with Vern for a while. But it got to a point later on where Vern and I just didn't see eye to eye. We'd gone to the same high school. We were both state champions. And it went back that far, you know. And then he put himself in the promotion seat. So it made it tough, you know. And he had to make some decisions, and some of them were good, some were bad. I'm not saying anything negative, you know. He did what he thought he had to do. Vince is still in business. Let's put it that way.
Mm-hmm.
I get my grandson wrestles with him, Curtis Axel. And in fact, he's in Europe right now. And he's doing very well with him, money wise. And Vince likes him. You know, and when you got to have good people around you when you got a billion-dollar business. And now they're going into China and Japan, and they've been in Japan, but Russia, Italy, France, the whole Europe scheme there. And they're all big promotions. You know, they work with they got their own satellite now that they work with. So it covers that like a blanket. So it's like another whole world over there. they got as many towns there now as they have in the United States. So it's big business. That's all I can